So, welcome to Chapter 9 here in Photoshop Tutorials. And Chapter 9 is going to concern itself with more of the physical damage photo retouching properties, like rips and scratches and things like that. But to get started off, I'm going to go to File and Open. And in Chapter 9, Folder 9.1, I'm going to open up Fixing Red Eye. Just wanted to briefly jump into photo retouching with a little bit of a more dominant red eye photo, as you can obviously see right here. So the first thing you would always do, what I would always recommend, is Command J. Duplicate your layer before you work on it. And the whole point of this little exercise is to point out that there should never be photos with red eye ever again. It is so easy to fix. So all I would have to do to fix a red eye condition like this, where the flash affected her eyes, obviously, is go to the fourth tool down on the right, press and hold, and I have at the bottom of that list a red eye tool. I don't even have to change anything on this. I'm just going to put the plus of that cursor in the red and click. Put the plus in the red, click. That is it. When I zoom out, we've got a nice, simple, believable photo. Not that demonic look of those red eyes there. Really basic, simple touch-up. If I zoomed in real close and you think, well, that didn't really make that as dark as I would like it to be, you can go to your burn tool. Hold Control and Option. We'll make a really small brush. And I'll set it to mid-tones for affecting the range of values. And I'll just burn in a little bit more of what the red eye tool already took care of, like that. Okay, then I can zoom out, and now that looks even better. So minor touch-ups. The whole point is you should never have red eye in your photos again. The only other thing I would do is when you're done, press and hold on the fourth tool and come back up to the top. Because this is something you're not going to use all the time, but it's nice to know that it is available. So I would reset it back up here to the spot healing brush so we can move on.